Hi student, today we are going to discuss about the some properties of rational number. So first we are going to discuss about the properties of rational number of closure property. So what is closure property? Suppose, so we follow the closure property in different four segments. First is addition. How we follow the closure property in addition? Are rational number follow the closure properties follow in addition? So if two rational number is added, then result is also a rational number. For example, if A upon B and C upon D is two rational number is added, then its result is also rational number. This is known as a closure property of addition. Suppose if we add 1 by 2 and 1 by 3, then result is 5 by 6. So this is also a rational number, means addition of two rational numbers is also a rational number, and subtraction is also. So addition is follow the rule of closure property in subtraction. In subtraction also, suppose if A upon B and C by D is subtracted, then the result is rational number. If 1 by 2 and 1 by 3 is subtracted, then result is 1 by 6, which is a rational number. Means subtraction is also follow the closure property. In multiplication is also, if we take two rational numbers, suppose we take 2 by 3 and 3 by 5, then it will be cancelled, then result is 2 by 5, means it is also a rational number. Means multiplication is also follow the closure properties of rational number. And in division, if we divide two numbers, two rational numbers, suppose AB is divided by CD, then the result is also a rational number. The result is also a rational number. We take any example, 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is divided by 4 by 5. Then result is become 2 by 5. So it is also a rational number. Means we can say that division is also follow the closure properties of rational number. In closure property, we have only discussed if we add or subtract two rational number or multiply two rational number or divide two rational number, then result is a rational number. Now our next property is commutative property. What do you mean by commutative property? If two rational number, suppose A by B plus C by D is added, then result is same as C by D and A by D when added. There is no effect. For example, if we add 1 by 2 and 1 by 3, either 1 by 3, 1 by 2, result will be same. This property is known as commutative property. So addition follow the rule of commutative property. But in subtraction, if A by B is subtracted CD, so the result is not same as when A by B is subtracted from C by D. So subtraction is not follow the rule of commutative property. In multiplication, when two rational number A by B and C by D is multiplied, then result is same as when C by D and multiply by A by B, the result is same. Means only addition and subtraction, addition and multiplication follow the rule of commutative property. In division also, when a rational number A by B divided by another rational number C by D, the result is not same as when C by D is divided by A by B. So division is also not follow the rule of cumulative property. Now our third property is associative property. What do you mean by the associative property? If three rational number a by b plus c by d and e by f is added, if we take two numbers together and they are added firstly and then after it will be added with e by f, then suppose if a by b plus c by d and e by f is added, means first we add if two numbers and another, then the third rational number, then result is same as when a by b plus these two c by d and e f added together and after that a by b, the result will be same. Means addition is follow the associative rule, but subtraction same as before example in commutative property, subtraction is also not follow the rule of associative property. In multiplication is also, in multiplication when a by b multiply by c by d multiply by e by f, if we take together these two numbers and after multiply these together number and after that e by f, the result will be same when a by b multiply by c by d and e by f, the result will be same. So associative properties of rational number is followed by in multiplication also, but in division it will be not follow. Now our next topic is additive inverse. What is additive inverse? Student, properties is very important in different competitive exam also, but student is not caring about the properties of rational number, but it is essential to know. In additive inverse, suppose we have a rational number a by b. So what is additive inverse? What number should be added in a by b, the result will become zero. It will be minus a by b. If we add minus a by b, then result will become zero. So many of the question is formed by this topic. If we ask what is the additive inverse of 4, so just you have take the answer will be minus 4. Only you have changed the sign. If I will ask the what is the additive inverse of minus 4, then you say that plus 4. You take any example. And now our next topic is multiplicative inverse. Suppose if we have a rational number a by b, so what do you mean by the multiplicative inverse? If we take a rational number a by b, then what number should be multiplied in a by b, the result will be 1. So it will be b by a. So what is the multiplicative inverse of a by b is b by a, then result will be 1. If we ask what is the multiplicative inverse of 5, then result is 1 by 5, your answer will be 1 by 5. What is the multiplicative inverse of 4? Then result will be 1 by 4, because it make the result is, the answer will be 1 by 5. In here, if we will ask what is the multiplicative inverse of 4, then you multiply 1 by 4. Your answer of multiplicative inverse is 1 by 4. So this is the multiplicative inverse. And our next topic is how we represent a rational number on the number line. For example, in previous class 7th, There are many rational number can be expressed. 4, 5, minus 2, and 2 by 5. So these complete number you clearly represent on the number line. But suppose if we take 2 by 5. So first of all, if we represent suppose 4. So make a number line and represent the number 0, 1 to take the equal distance 1, 2, 3, 4. If you want to write some negative numbers, then you can also write here. And we have represent 4, then we take 0 to 4, because we have take always starting our number from 0. So this distance is the 4 unit. So this is the representation of rational number 4. So similarly, you can represent 5 and minus 2 also. But if any fractional number given, suppose minus 2 by 5 is given, then how can you represent it? So first of all, you just divide 2 by 5 represent in the decimal form. 5 4 is 20. You just decide. This is 0.4. So first of all, you represent the line, means the representation of minus 2 by 5 is approx 0.4, and it will be lies between 0 to minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 1, 2, 3. And here is pi part. So you take this number will lies in 0 to 1, and you just make pi parts of 0 to 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 parts. And upper part is 2. Then you take second part. And now you have just represent the number, and the number will lies in 0 to minus 1. So you make 5 part between 0 to 1, and take the denominator, numerator is 2, then you take 2 parts, 1 part and second part. The representation will be represent is minus 2 by 5. So thank you, student, and continuously, we will upload your next video of class 8 mathematics.